Hello friends, welcome to Java training session 8. This is Haradhan once again to let you know loop introduction, simple for loop and nested for loop in Java. So what is Java loops? There may be situation when you need to execute a block of code several number of times. In general, statements are executed sequentially. The first statement in a function is executed first and followed by second and so on for the rest of the statement, right? So loop is generally used when there is a repetitive execution required. Okay, in Java there are three types of loop available. The first is for loop, then while loop and do while loop. So in the for loop itself there are three kind of for loop available. One is simple for loop, the second is nested for loops, and third is enhanced for loop. So today I will let you know the simple and nested for loops. So enhanced for loops actually used for traversing the array element. Right now it will not be easy to understand. Once you understand array properly, then it will be easy for you to understand that particular loop. So I will cover that loop during the session for array. No need to worry. So what is Java for loop, right? For loop repeats a block of statement for a specified number of times. In case my number iteration is fixed, it is recommended to use the for loop. Okay, so there is syntax already provided for loop, the for and the start value and the end value, then increment or decrement operator. In case I want to increase my value or decrease the value, so I can use it, right? And then the statement, then the I mean particular second bracket is closing, right? Here example already there. So I will show you how the different kind of for loop we can create in Java and how we can create also the enhanced for loop. Okay, so here I already created a project Java training session 8 in the package training, and the project is Java training project. Okay, so first I will create a simple for loop using the increment operator. So what is the syntax? For, then you need to, in the second bracket, you need to declare a data type integer. Okay, then you need to declare a variable. Suppose I'm assigning some value for initial value. Suppose I equal to say 0. Okay, then it will be the initial value, then it is the end value, right? Start value and end value, right? Here I already showed you start value and end value, right? So suppose I have end value, I want to, and then every time you need to enter with colon, semicolon. Then I less equal to 10, suppose, or 9. Okay, it will go till 9. Less equal to means it will go till 9. Okay, if it is less 9, so it will go till 8. Okay, then I want to increment, right? Because I am starting from 0 and I will go to 9. I want to increment. So I plus plus. So it will increment by 1. Then I want to display the value of I. Then the second bracket. Then SYSO, you need to enter here I. Okay, so you can see error message gone, right? So that is the syntax, right? For, then you need to declare data type, because it is integer. So I'm declaring a variable, starting value, start, right? Here it is start value and end value, right? I want to go to 9, equal, less or equal to 9, and increment operator, right? And I want to print the value of I. Okay, so let's run the code and let's see what is happening. So you can see in the output, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, till 9, it is displaying, right? If I remove that equal sign, so what it will display? Let's run it again. Okay, if you run it, you can see here. So it is displaying till 8, because it will go till 8, because it is not equal to 9, right? It is less than 9, so it will go till 8, right? It is starting from 0 and it is going to till 8, so that's why it will work for the increment operator. Here suppose for 0 to, I mean less than 9 means 0 to 8, I want to display all the value except suppose any particular one value. Suppose I don't want to display 5, right? So how can I do that? So here in the for loop you need to use another if loop, right? If I equal to, I not equal to 5, I want to display everything, right? So I equal to 5, I don't want to display. So I not equal to 5, right? I don't want to display it. Then another second bracket. Then here I need to close it with another second bracket. Right? So what is the objective of the code? I want to display all the value except 5, right? So for the in the for loop itself, I want to include a if loop. So it will consider that, it will not consider the value I equal to 5, except everything will be printed. So let's run the code and let's see. Right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is not there, 6, 7, 8. So I don't want to display I equal to 5. Suppose in case I don't want to display 5 and 7, rest of the value I want to display. So you need to use an AND operator here. And I not equal to 7, right? I don't want to display 5 and 7, rest of the value for I equal to 0 to I equal to 8. Less equal less 9 means I equal to 8. I want to display, right? So if you need to add a end, I mean the if loop, and you need to use the AND operator so that I equal to 5 and I equal to 7 will not be displayed, right? You can display the rest of the value. You can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 5 is not displaying. After 4, right? 6 is displaying, 7 is also not displaying, 8 is displaying, right? So my code is working fine, right? Then, in case, if you, right? If you want to use the decrement operator, so how will it work, right? So for decrement operator, you need to give the highest value, n value, right? Highest value, and then it will go to the decrement order. It will go to the down, right? Suppose I want to start with I equal to 20. Then I want to go I greater than equal to. I want to go till greater equal to 15. That means it will go till 15. Then I want to decrease one by one, right? I want to decrease. Okay. So it will decrease one by one, right? And let's see. So here you need to give the start value. So I am starting from 20. Then it will go till equal to 15. Okay. And then it will decrease by one. From 20 it will decrease one by one. So 20, 19, 18, 17, 16. And it will till go to I equal to 15. So let's run the code and let's see. What is happening here, right? It is displaying, right? Starting from 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, right? It is going in that way, okay? If you go till greater equal to 15, so what will happen? It will go till 16, but will not consider the 15 one, okay? Let's run the code. You can see 20, 19, 18, 17 and 16 is coming. It is not going considering 15 because I get 15. Similar way, in case I don't want to display, suppose a particular value, suppose I don't want to display 18. So you need to enter a if loop here. If I not equal to suppose 18, then you need to enter add with bracket here and you need to close with that loop. So here it will start from 20. It will go till 16, but it will not consider that 18. So it will display all the rest of the value. Right, you can see 20, 19, 17, 16, 18 is not considering. It is not displaying. Similar way, if you don't want to display 17 also along with 18, how you need to do it? Enter bracket here and enter AND operator. And here you need to enter 17 also. Okay, I need to close with that one. So it will suppose I want to display till 10. Okay, that means 11. It will start from 20 and it will go till 11 and decrease one by one, but it will not display 18 and 17, right? Or suppose 16. I don't want to display 18 and 16. So let's run the code and let's see the output. You can see the output is 20, 19 and 18 is not there because 18 I have, don't want to display it, right? And 16 is not there also here, right? 8, 19, 17, 15 till 11, right? Because greater than 10 means it is 11, it's coming, right? So my for loop using the increment and decrement operator is working fine. Okay. So then I want to show you the nested for loop. So nested for loop is what, right? I already showed you the nested if and else loop, right? So nested is nothing, a loop within a loop, right? That is called nested loop. Suppose for first I am declaring a loop, suppose integer I starting with suppose 0, then I it will go till suppose say it will go till 4 less equal to 4, okay, and I plus plus, okay. Okay, that is the loop, and you need to enclose to this bracket, right? Okay, so here it need to give the semicolon. So fine, right? And so my already loop is already created. One loop using the integer I, right? Here within the loop, I want to create another loop for integer, suppose j, and because same variable will not allow you to enter multiple time, right? You need to enter with j variable. Suppose j is also starting with suppose 1, say, and j will go till j less equal to suppose it will go till 4 also, okay, then j plus plus, right? Here I need to give some bracket. And because that particular loop I need to close with, right? Okay, then I want to display I and j both, right? So how I need to write it? So I plus concatenation operator, then I want to give some space, right? And then plus j, okay? So let's see. Here I have declared a loop, right? First loop which starting with 0 and it will go till 4, right? And it will increment one by one, right? Then I am declaring another variable j within that loop starting with 1 and it will go till 4 and it will increment one by one, and then I want to display I and j, okay? So let's run the code, then I will tell you how the particular nested loop is working, right? Here no space is there, I need to enter some space here, sorry, here, so that it will be easy to understand. Otherwise it is, you can see, right, that particular word is 31, 32 is coming, but it is not like that. If you enter some space here, so it will be display in the space, it will also, right, it is displaying like that only. So space is there, right? I have entered some space. So what is happening? First the upper loop, right, outer loop will play the role. So first I will start with 0, then for the outer loop, inner loop will run, right? So here you can see outer loop for 0 and inner loop it will run 1 2 3 4, right? It will go till 4, right? So for 0 inner loop, outer loop 0, it is our inner loop is executing 4 times, 1 2 3 4, then it will again move back to the outer loop and it will increment the value by 1, right? So it will 1, outer loop will be 1. For outer loop, again inner loop will run from j equal to 1 to j equal to 4, right? Here you can see. So for outer loop 1, inner loop is 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, again it will control goes to the outer loop and it will increment by 1. So 2, right, outer loop, and for outer loop, inner loop will run 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Again, controls go to the outer loop. It will increment by 1. It will move to 3. And for 3, outer loop 3, inner loop 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 will be there. Okay. Then, outer loop again move to 3 plus 1, 4. And inner loop will again run from 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. You can see the output. That's way, right. So, first outer loop 0, inner loop 1, 2, 3, 4. Outer loop 1, inner loop 1, 2, 3, 4. outer loop 2, one inner loop 1, 2, 3, 4, outer loop 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and outer loop 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's why it is running. So first, outer loop will run, and then for each, for that condition, inner loop will run. All the steps, okay? Then again, control go to the outer loop, it will increment or decrement whatever is there in the test cases. So again, based on that, it will run. So that's why, okay, we can run it for nested loop, right? Suppose here, I want to decrease it one by one, right? Suppose it will start with 3 and it will go to getter equal to say 1, okay? And j minus minus. Let's run it, how it is behave, okay? So, for I equal outer loop, it will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And for inner loop, it will start from 3 and it will go to 1. That means 3 to 1. Let's run the code and let's see how the output is coming. You can see the output, right? So, for outer loop, 0, 3 to 1, inner loop, 1, 3 to 1 again. For outer loop 2, 3 to 1 again. For outer loop 3, 3 to 1 again. For outer loop 4, 3 to 1 again. So, that's why it is, right, working, okay? Okay, so that's all about for, Java loop introductions and for simple Java for loop and the nested for loops. So thank you all for watching my videos. In case you are enjoying my videos and learning automation testing along with Java, please like, share my videos and definitely don't forget to subscribe my channel. Post your valuable comment for any input or suggestion. Stay tuned for my next video. Thank you.